What's going on, everyone? Dots Gaming here, and today I'm bringing you guys 10 tips for getting started in Black Desert Online in 2021. Now, I did make one of these videos last year, which I'm going to link in the description below, and all the tips in that video are still completely relevant. So if you guys do want to go check out that video, I would definitely recommend watching that after this one, because what I want to do for this video is not cover any of the same tips that I did last year. Like I said, I rewatched the video, see if anything was out of date. And honestly, most of it was still totally relevant. I didn't want to just remake the same video again, but I wanted to give you guys 10 brand new tips to help you get started this year on your BDO adventures. And starting things off, we are going to go with our first tip. And that is going to be getting your pets and fairy are very, very important. So the way that pets work in BDO is a bit different than other games. Pets can help you auto loot when you are killing things and going throughout the world. So it makes grinding a lot more efficient. If you're out there grinding mobs, instead of having to periodically stop all the time and actually loot things off the ground, the pets will do it for you. Pets have different tiers, different perks, different rarities. And I'm not trying to go into a full pet guide here, but it's very important to have the pets. You can have up to 5. And even if you could just get some pets, you know, even some low tier pets just to get yourself started, it's definitely recommended. And if you do the main quest of the game, which is one of my tips from my original video, you can get a couple of pets for free, which will help you get started on your adventures and get, you know, get some pets. But if you do feel you want to flesh out the rest of your pet count, you can feel free to purchase some off the Pearl Shop. Also, getting a fairy is very, very important. So you're going to be able to get these things called Lila's Petals as you actually play and quest through the game. You can get them through a bunch of different sources. And basically what you want to do is every time you have 2 of these, you're going to want to bring these to the Kamasylph Temple to the west of Hydel, and you are able to get a fairy. That's a different companion that's able to follow you around. And the fairy companion gives you a bunch of different perks. There's different tiers of the fairy, similarly to the pets. And the fairy can offer some different perks that the pets don't offer, bunch of different things. And it's just another good thing to have on your account so that you get some extra bonuses while you play. My second tip is going to be to spend your pearls wisely. I think one of the big things that people ask when they first start playing BDO is they go, okay, you know, I've been liking the game, I want to invest a little bit of money to it, but I don't know what are the best things to buy. I know that was a question I had when I first started. Now, I personally recommend as a new player to prioritize account-wide things, such as the value pack, which is kind of like this game's subscription type of deal. Instead of actually signing up for a sub, you buy the value pack and it lasts for, you know, a certain duration based off of how much money you spend and how long you buy it for. I would also recommend buying pets, maids, or butlers, which are basically ways to access your storage or your central auction house while you are away from those places, as well as a campsite. A campsite is a thing that has a bunch of different perks in it. It's something that you can place on the ground while you're out adventuring, and it basically has like a repair thing and a bunch of other perks that you can have with you while you're out grinding, so you have to go back to town less often. So those are the big things that I recommend focusing on. But if you have some extra money to spend, I also do recommend looking into inventory space and weight, you know, for whatever your main character is, as those two things are going to be massive, massive, massive quality of life. And then, of course, if you really want to have some fun, go for some nice fashion. Moving on to our third tip, and it is going to be completing the adventure logs for additional stats. You're going to notice that you have a thing on your user interface called adventure logs. And basically, when you complete these, they have certain tasks in them that you can do. If you scroll through them, you can see there's a bunch of different things to do. And as you do them, you get permanent stats for your characters. It's just permanent stats that are not tied to gear, not tied to anything, and it's just ways for you to get additional stats on your character. And so if you're kind of looking for something to do, and if you have some spare time, these are a really, really good way to give yourself something to do, and on top of that, also make yourself and your account a lot stronger. Our next tip, our fourth tip, is going to be getting a good horse. It is extremely important in BDO to have a good horse because there is no fast travel in the game. It's really, really important. Once again, like everything else I've talked about, there's multiple different tiers of these horses. And actually, it goes up to about 8, and then it gets into the whole dream horse courser thing. And I'm not going to explain that for this video, but for the purposes of what we're talking about, know that there's about 8 tiers of horses. And when you go and do the main quest, you actually get a tier 5 horse, which is pretty cool. But Horses, again, like the fairies, like the pets, also have different perks, different things that they can do and have on them. And there are three things that you want to prioritize when looking for a good horse. You want to prioritize sprint, drift, and instant acceleration. Sprint is the ability for you to be able to hold down shift and have your horse run fast. Instant acceleration is exactly what it sounds like. Gives you a nice boost of speed while you are actually using your horse. And the good thing is that the tier 5 horse that you get from questing has both sprint and instant acceleration already on it, which is really, really cool. But the third perk that you also want is something called drift, because the reason you want this is because you can actually drift cancel while you are riding your horse. So basically what you would do is you're going to hold shift to sprint, and then you're going to use, let's say, A and S. So you basically pump the brakes a little bit. You have your horse swerve slightly, and then you press instant acceleration right after you do the drift, and you will get an instant burst of speed. And basically what drift does is it helps you like reset the cooldown on the instant acceleration. So you're able to just sprint, drift, instant excel, sprint, drift, instant excel, and you can get from point A to point B really quickly by doing this. Now, if you want a really solid way to get a really good horse for much cheaper, what I would recommend doing is you can actually go to the horse market at any stables and you can take a look at what horses are for sale. This is how you would get a horse basically outside the ones that you get from your questing. There's other ways to do it, but for most people, this is going to be a really good way to do it unless you want to get into horse taming. Now, there's a type of horse in the game called a courser, and the courser horse is good for a lot of end game players because it allows them to segue into like the best, highest tiered, crazy horses in the game, right? But if you're just looking for a really, really good horse and you're not looking to get into that super end game system quite yet, because most people aren't when they first started, you want to get a tier 8 horse that's a non-courser. It's personally what I have. It's a really fast horse, really efficient, really good for most of your needs, but because it's not a courser, it can't be turned into one of those crazy, insane, hyper-speed endgame horses. So a lot of endgame players might, like super endgame players, might not want them as much. Therefore, the price is a lot lower. So that's a good way to get a really good horse, save some money on it. So just a quick tip about the horse. I know this one was a bit longer, but wanted to really go into this because I don't see it talked about as much. Our fifth tip, guys, is going to be to set up a node, housing, and worker system that works for your needs. If you guys have no idea how the nodes, housing, and worker system even work, I do have a beginner guide linked in the description below from last year, still completely up to date, that you can watch and understand how this system works. But in terms of how to set up this type of system for you, it's totally dependent on your needs. Whether or not you're a life skiller, whether or not you only want to grind, whether or not you want to do something in between. Personally, the way that I have my node system set up for myself is that I typically don't like to actively do life skills when I'm playing the game. If I'm at my computer actually playing, I like to just, you know, play the game and do combat. So typically I will, you know, have my character go out in the world and grind. So I focused my nodes around getting things from the nodes that will generate the most income just raw out of the node. So I can just get the stuff into the bank, list it on the MP, and it will just sell. Another thing that I focused on specifically from my nodes is items that can be basically processed or turned into things while I'm AFK. I like doing all of my life skills while I'm AFK. I like leaving my Shy and Hydel to process while I'm away from my computer or while I'm working, and I just minimize BDO to the tray, and I just have her do a ton of different stuff. So I have my nodes and all the stuff that I gather, like I said, set up for my personal desires and the way that I personally like to play the game. So I would recommend kind of thinking about what you want to do, looking up some nodes that then suit those needs, and then setting yourself up for success. I personally do recommend, if you're looking for like a main town hub to kind of work everything around, I highly recommend Hydel. It's a really central location in the map. It's got a lot of good nodes surrounding it, so I definitely recommend kind of setting up shop there. Our next tip, tip number 6, is going to be that when there are active season servers, make new characters on those servers. Currently, at the time of making this video, there are no season servers at the moment, but basically what these are is that they are servers that are good for new and returning players to basically level up characters nice and quick and get some really, really good like battle pass almost type bonuses while you play on those servers. So I definitely recommend, if there is an active season server when it comes back, make your character there. And then when you're done with that season server, when you're it's done and over with, you can transfer your character to be a regular character and you can play on any of the normal servers. And plus, I believe on the season servers, PvP is not active, so you can't be killed while you're out doing your stuff. Tip number seven is, again, probably one that might be a little bit temporary. Tip number seven is the Oasis Vendor. It's a very good way to get good items for cheap. I believe the Oasis Vendor came out back in 2020, and it's a vendor near all of the different stables that can give you a bunch of items for cheap, one silver apiece, really good food, stuff for your horse. You also have some gear that you can do to get help yourself get started. Like, the Oasis Vendor just has a ton of good stuff in it for really, really cheap. It came around the time that COVID started, and it is still here. So I definitely recommend taking advantage of it while it is still here and still active. And when your character, as your character is leveling up and you can get the gear, I would definitely take advantage of it. And then on top of that, you know, get all of the food and horse stuff from it so that you can take advantage of all these good things for for very, very cheap prices. My eighth tip is to turn your Naru gear that you get from questing into Narchilian gear. This is a recently added feature, and I effing love it. The Naru gear is a new type of gear that you get from doing the main quest, and it's meant to basically segue your character towards the end of the game and towards the end game grinding when as you go through the quest line. Now, basically, what you're going to do is you're going to get this gear as you quest, and you're also going to see in your inventory, you're collecting a lot of these things called beginner blackstones. You have one for weapon and one for armor. You 100% want to save all of these, as well as all the Naru pieces you get from leveling. What you then want to do is go to the Black Spirit, okay, and you're going to enhance the Naru gear, which you're basically is going to be trying to improve its rating, with the beginner blackstones, with your goal of getting these Naru gear to pen rating, which is the highest gear enhancement level. Once you actually improve your armor pieces, your head, your chest, your boots, and your gloves, as well as your weapons, you can go to Fugar at any stables and turn that gear in to get Narchilian gear. You could also do your accessories if you are so inclined. You can improve those as well. But you get a lot of really good accessories from just actually leveling up from the level up reward. So I typically recommend just looking for the Kaposha ones that you get from leveling. Smashing the Naru accessories can be a bit of a pain in the butt. So you can just use the Kaposha ones from leveling or get some really cheap ones off the MP. But I definitely recommend at the very least doing, like I said, the body armor pieces, like those four that I talked about, as well as your main weapon, your sub weapon, and your awakening weapon. This gear is essentially try and a half. For those of you who don't know how the rating system is, pen is the top, tet is the second highest, and then try is the third highest. So basically the Narchilian gear is like try 0.5 in a way. So it's a really, really good set of armor and weapons to get yourself started going into the end of the game and start your initial grinding. And it's really not that hard to get. You have all the Naru gears, a very high enhancement chance. You get a crap load of those blackstones through the main quest. So as long as you do the main quest through, I'd say at least Altanova, finish the Altanova quest line, you should have every single piece at pen. Should be no problem. I know that's what happened to me when I just recently leveled my Hashishin, so it can be done very, very easily. My ninth tip is to get the infinite potion. So I'm going to link a guide in the description below on how to actually get this. I would recommend doing this once your character, you know, is leveled up, you've gone through the Awakening and or Succession quest lines, you've got your Narchilian gear on, and you're ready to kind of start moving into some more end game stuff. I just want to mention it here in this beginner tips video because a lot of people I don't think will know it exists when they first start playing. So in BDO, there are potions that you can drink to basically give you more resources or give you more health, and they have a very low cooldown. And so that means that you're going to be churning through pots really, really quick. But there's an item in the game that can take quite a while to get that is an infinite potion. It does not ever run out. So I would recommend once you know are looking for something to do, once you get that, like I said, initial gear and you go through your initial process and have your characters, you know, you're starting to grind and stuff, I definitely recommend looking into getting this. It's a huge quality of life item, and especially one of the fairy perks that you can get that I mentioned back in tip number one is that it will use the potion for you automatically, so you don't even have to use it. So you can have a fairy potioning for you automatically that never runs out. It's quite a good thing to have set up. I'm still actually working on getting it myself, so definitely recommend looking into it. And then my 10th and final tip is to get the shared family inventory and because you can store consumables like worker food, pet food, and horse food in that storage. This is a relatively new thing that's come to the game as far as I know, because it wasn't here when I played last year. And basically, you can get these this quest from the Black Spirit that will take you to Shikatu, and you can go to him, do a quest, and you can unlock family inventory. It'll be, if you go through the Black Spirit's quest, you will see it says Shikatu's invitation. You basically want to get that, go talk to him, and go through that quest line. Again, I will leave a link for this quest line in the description below, and I would definitely recommend doing this, because if you don't, it's not that big of a deal. Like, let's say you're playing on your main and your pets need to eat. Typically, I like to keep pet food on an alt so that it's not weighing down my main, and my main can grind for longer, so I'd have to quickly switch over to my alt, feed the pets, switch back over to my main and go play. Or if I need to feed my workers, I gotta switch back over to a different alt, feed the workers, and then go back to my main to play. But with the family storage, you can just shove all those consumables in there and you'll have it across your entire account. But guys, that is going to be it. 10 new tips for helping you guys get started in BDO. Like I said, if you're, you know, if some of this went a little bit over your head, I would definitely recommend checking out my other top 10 tips video. It's linked in the description. Like I said, that one is definitely a bit more grassroots. But like I said, because all that those tips were still relevant today, I didn't want to just remake and repeat the video. I wanted to make something brand new for you guys and give you 10 additional tips. So hopefully you did find this helpful. And if you did, I'd appreciate it if you left a like on it. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. And guys, to keep up to date with all the BDO and other MMORPG content I have here on my YouTube channel, I'd appreciate if you hit that sub button as well as the bell to keep those notifications on so you always know when I upload. Thank you guys so much for stopping by today. I do very much appreciate it. As always, I'm Dots Gaming, and I'll see you all in the next one.